No, so the simple answer is not all compound. And I had to think about that. My initial answer was yes, they all do, but they don't all. And that's especially, that's a lot more common in the way someone structures an investment. And the one that came to mind was rent, right? Just because we look at a lot of contracts. So there is a market, you know, so when you own an asset like a house or a rental property, then there are two things that drive your return there, right? The one is how much cash you get from rent, and the other is how much you get from the thing appreciating, right? But you're the one who's writing the contract on how much rent changes. So if you didn't write it in a way that it's going to compound for you, then, right? Like the amount, holy shit, it does all compound. I take this back.
It depends.
How does it depend?
It depends on how you structure your investment, on how you manage your investment. So compounding is literally when you have interest and that interest earns interest. So if everything that you earn from your principal, you put it back, all your investments compound. But a lot of, I'm very bad with this. Whenever I get some money back, I usually feel like, okay, let me treat myself. And then I take money out, which means that my compounding effect is diluted. So you want to make sure that you always, if this is your goal, then you want to make sure that you always put your money back in the investment and you don't let it sit in your account or wherever for any amount of time, because then it messes up the math. Yeah.
So the answer is yes, it compounds if you put it all back in, but you can screw it up.
Yes.
Right? Cool. I confuse myself.